quick advice. Whenever you guys, want to scan your documents, I'm over here at Flying J. Best place to scan documents, truck stops, whenever you stop to fill up gas, DEF or whatever. So I'm over here scanning my documents. Pretty quick, easy. I'm going to go ahead and get started. Gotta have chicken wings, man. Every time you fill up, you get points. You can use your points on whatever. Food, they got electronics, they got whatever at truck stops. Anything trucker needs. Today, it's all about the chicken wings. All right, man. Probably the worst day to do this. And that's pretty much cleaning out the back of your trailer. Ugh. It's gonna suck. It's gonna suck balls, man. Balls of steel. Alright. Oh, not bad. Alright, so there's a few cardboard pieces. Where I'm going to Hershey. The Hershey factory, chocolate factory. Let me lock this door back here, that way it don't close on me while I'm cleaning out the trailer. Alright, not bad. I could probably just kick them out. Thought it'd be worse. Anyways, so where I'm going is Hershey. And they're very, very strict on their, policy as far as bringing your trailers. They gotta be really clean because you're hauling chocolate. Even though the chocolate's in like a huge box and then it's in the next box. It's like in four different boxes until you finally get to the chocolate. So, oh well, here we go. All right, so these freaking warehouse workers, every time they unload that trailer, they always be leaving freaking food. You make all this trash, and it's our job to clean out the trailer. So, this is probably the most annoying part about trucking, is you gotta clean out your own trailers. There are some companies that require you to show a receipt that you actually took it to a, like a trailer wash. And this isn't one of those companies, so I have to do it myself. The ones that do require to take it to a trailer wash and show receipt, usually you can just save those receipts and you'll get reimbursed. But in this case, since they don't take it or they don't require it, I ain't gonna pay $31 to clean the back of my trailer when I can just do it myself. And it'll only take like 10, 15 minutes. The reason why it's taking longer is also because I don't have a broom. Because I just barely got my truck yesterday and I'm totally spaced out getting like a broom, just little things for my truck. Also, getting, gloves. When I was eating my chicken wings, it tasted like diesel. And that sucked. Oh well, just little, tips, pointers. All right, there you go. Not as clean as I wanted it to be, but without a broom, that's pretty much the best you can do. You gotta love driving in the snow, man. Driving in the snow. So we're in Utah, and right now it's not snowing too bad. It's just a little bit, itty bitty. Probably maybe an inch on the floor. And so, because there's only an inch, it's like kind of turning into, water pretty much. So, when you're driving in the snow, probably the biggest advice would be, do not put on your cruise control. one of the worst, a lot of truck driver accidents that happen in the snow is because they either put it on cruise control or because they're going too fast for the conditions. So yeah, man. I forgot to mention. Oh, you can't see it. Dang it. Really? Hold on. I'll turn on the light. Can you see it now? Kind of? No? Can you see it now a little bit? Anyways, okay, so it comes with this coax cable. I guess the guy before me installed antennas on the truck, and you definitely got to buy this. You know, we got this at the DI as well. DI is the best place to get anything that you need for cheap. Whoa. All right. Oh yeah, I gotta show you guys the antenna. Wait, hold up.
Let me see.
Go on.
You want me to close it?
Yeah. All right, okay, so that's the antenna right there. You guys can see, normally that's not installed in any trucks unless you buy it yourself, so it looks like the guy bought it and installed it. It's kind of a small one. Or did he take it off of that little mount? I'll find out.